RSV stands for respiratory syncytial virus, and it has for a long time been one of the most common respiratory viruses to cause respiratory viral infection in children. If a child is starting to have symptoms of an upper respiratory infection with a lot of nasal congestion and drainage and some cough, those alone are not signs of concern with any respiratory infection, including RSV infection. However, if it seems like your child is having more difficulty breathing, they're breathing faster, they're using additional muscles, maybe those muscles in between the ribs or belly muscles to help them breathe, or if at any point you're concerned that they might be getting dehydrated, those would be signs that should prompt a call to your pediatrician's office or an urgent evaluation with a physician. So the most likely places for RSV and other respiratory viruses to be transmitted could be in schools or in daycare settings if children are in those settings with other infected children. And so that's especially important if children aren't having good hand hygiene in between contact with other children, or maybe having touched something that's contaminated with some of those respiratory secretions. It is possible that viral transmission could happen in the home if somebody in the home has become symptomatic with one of those respiratory viral infections. So that's why it would be really important if anyone in the home is having symptoms of a respiratory viral infection to do your best to isolate younger children and infants from that infected individual as much as possible, and to make sure there's extra hand washing going on before there is contact with that infant or young child.